In this video, I'm going to finish out the compound inequalities worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab. You can find this within the equations and inequalities section. So let's pick back up with number 15. In number 15, we have an AND compound inequality. However, our variable is on the left, middle, and the right. So we're going to have to manipulate this compound inequality to get the variable only in the middle. I think the easiest way to do this is split it up. Look at 4b plus 18 is less than or equal to negative 12b minus 14. And then look at negative 12b minus 14 is less than or equal to 14 minus 5b. So let's solve this left inequality first. I'm going to start by adding 14 to both sides. And I'm also going to subtract 4b from both sides. When I do this, my 14 will cancel out on my right, and my 4b will cancel out on my left, leaving us with the terms with b on the right-hand side of the inequality and the terms without on the left. 18 plus 14 will be 32, and that's going to be less than or equal to negative 12b minus 4b, which is negative 16b. Our next step is going to be to divide by negative 16. Remember, when we divide by a negative, we have to flip this inequality sign. So 32 divided by negative 16 is negative 2, and that's going to be greater than or equal to b. Now let's solve for our right inequality. Negative 12b minus 14 is less than or equal to 14 minus 5b. I'll start by adding 14 to both sides. These 14s will cancel out. 14 plus 14 will give me a positive 28, and then I'll also add 5b to both sides. And in doing so, negative 12b plus 5b equals negative 7b. So I'll just have negative 7b on the left-hand side. Negative 5b will cancel out with 5b, so I'll just have my 28 on the right. Then I'll divide both sides by negative 7 to get that b, flipping the inequality, is greater than or equal to negative 4. So I have negative 2 is greater than or equal to b, and b is greater than or equal to negative 4. So I can write this as one compound inequality. That negative 4, we know, is less than or equal to b, and that b is less than or equal to negative 2. So I have that negative 4 is less than or equal to b, which is less than or equal to negative 2. Graphing that, I'll circle, fill in negative 4, circle, fill in negative 2, and shade in everything in between. For number 16, I have another AND compound inequality. In this first inequality, I'll start by subtracting 4a from both sides. That'll give me that 8 is greater than 7a plus 15. Then I'll subtract 15 from both sides. 8 minus 15 is negative 7, so I'll have that negative 7 is greater than 7a. Then I'll divide both sides by 7 to get that negative 1 is greater than a. And from my other inequality, 13 minus 14a is less than or equal to 13 minus 3a. I'll start by subtracting 13 from both sides. That'll give me negative 14a is less than or equal to negative 3a. Then I'll add 14a to both sides to get that 0 is less than or equal to 9a. When I divide both sides by 9, I get that 0 is less than or equal to a. So I have that negative 1 is greater than a, and 0 is less than or equal to a. We can think of each of these as a is less than negative 1, and a is greater than or equal to 0. But look, when I go to graph this, a is less than negative 1, I'm circling negative 1 and shading everything to the left. And a is greater than or equal to 0. I'm circling, filling in 0 and shading everything to the right. However, there is no intersection between these two. And in order for it to be an AND compound inequality, the intersection is what is graphed. And if we have no intersection, there is no solution. There is not any value of a that we can plug in to both this right inequality and this left inequality that will be true for both. Let's move on to number 17. In number 17, again, we have an and compound inequality. Solving this left inequality first, I'll start by subtracting 7p from both sides. And doing this, my 7p on my right will cancel out. I only want terms with p on my left, so I gotta get rid of this 13. In order to do that, I'll add 13 to both sides, so that my 13 will cancel out. I'll have 8p minus 7p, which is 1p, which is simply p, and that's less than or equal to negative 2 plus 13, which is a positive 11. Over here, in my next inequality, I'll start by subtracting 2p. So I'm moving my terms with p to the left-hand side of my inequality, and my terms without p, I'll move to the right, so I'll subtract 20. 2p minus 2p is 0, and 20 minus 20 is 0. 4p minus 2p is 2p, and that is less than 14 minus 20, which is negative 6. My next step, I'll divide by 2 to get that p is less than negative 3. So I have p is less than or equal to 11, and p is less than negative 3. When I go to graph this, p is less than or equal to 11, I would circle 11, which is somewhere over here, and shade everything to the left. I also have p is less than negative 3, so I would circle negative 3 and shade everything to the left. Remember, since this is a compound inequality with and, we're only looking at the intersection, which you can see is where negative 3 is circled and everything else shaded to the left. That's where each of these inequalities overlap and is therefore our solution. So p is less than negative 3 is the solution for this compound inequality. Let's move on to number 18. In number 18, we have another and compound inequality. We have that 5v plus 10 is less than or equal to negative 4v minus 17, and we have that negative 4v minus 17 is less than 9 minus 2v. So solving this first inequality, I'll add 4v to both sides. That'll give me that 9v plus 10 is less than or equal to negative 17. Then I'll subtract 10 from both sides to get that 9v is less than or equal to negative 27. When I divide both sides by 9, I get that v is less than or equal to negative 3. For this right inequality, I'll start by adding 4v to both sides. I'll get that negative 17 is less than 9 plus 2v, since negative 2v plus 4v is 2v. Then I'll subtract 9 from both sides to get that negative 26 is less than 2v. My next step, I'll divide both sides by 2 to get that negative 13 is less than v. And I know that v is less than or equal to negative 3, and negative 13 is less than v. So I'm going to write this as one compound inequality where v is in the middle. So I have v is less than or equal to negative 3, and I have negative 13 is less than v. So negative 13 is less than v, which is less than or equal to negative 3, is my solution. And I'll go ahead and graph that. I'll circle the negative 13, and I'll circle and fill in the negative 3. Then I'll shade everything in between. Moving on to number 19, I have an or compound inequality. So I'm going to be doing the union of the two inequalities. I'll start by solving the second inequality. I'll add 10r to both sides to get that 8 is greater than or equal to 15 plus r. Then I'll subtract 15 from both sides to get that negative 7 is greater than or equal to r, which we can rewrite as r is less than or equal to negative 7. In my other inequality, I'll start by subtracting 16 from both sides to get that 14r plus 4 is less than 14r. Then I'll subtract 14r from both sides to get that 4 is less than 0. I know that 4 is less than 0 is not possible, but I have 4 is less than 0 or r is less than or equal to negative 7. So even though I cannot plot 4 is less than 0, I can graph r is less than or equal to negative 7. So I can circle negative 7, fill that in, and shade everything to the left. So r is less than or equal to negative 7 is my solution in number 19. And lastly, number 20. Before I go over the answer to number 20, please remember to give me a thumbs up on this video, and also, while you're at it, subscribe to my channel. That way you're updated when I come out with new videos. In number 20, what's going to be the union of this inequality and this inequality? Let's solve for x plus 18 is greater than or equal to 8x plus 4. I'm going to start by subtracting x from both sides to get that 18 is greater than or equal to 7x plus 4. Then I'll subtract 4 from both sides to get that 14 is greater than or equal to 7x. Then when I divide both sides by 7, I'll get that 2 is greater than or equal to x, which we could also write as x is less than or equal to 2. And my other inequality, I'll start by adding 15 to both sides. So I'll get that 15x is less than or equal to 15x plus 20. Then when I subtract 15x from both sides, I get that 0 is less than or equal to 20, which 0 is always less than or equal to 20. Therefore, I can plug any value of x into this inequality and it will hold true. Therefore, my solution is all real numbers. So I'll shade in the entire number line. And if you want to double check, go ahead and plug in random x values and see if they're always true. Comment below with what values you plugged in and found out that this inequality was true for. Also, if you have any questions or if you need clarification on any of the problems in this video, please leave me a message in the comments below and I'll get back to you as quickly as possible.